friends, I'm here with another Trader Joe's haul. This time it's just Trader Joe's, not including Costco. I'm actually doing really well as far as making sure that I do use up the products that I buy at Costco and over at Trader Joe's and not just stocking it up into the pantry or into the refrigerator or not opening it up. And then you're just using a quarter of it and then throwing it out after realizing it's been there for like 2 weeks or past 2 weeks. So that has happened quite a bit during the last year. So this year, I'm more focusing on making sure that the salads that I do get, I don't necessarily need to get it over at Costco because it's just too much of it and we can't consume all of it in the amount of time that we need to before it does go bad. So just wanted to show you a lot of basics, a lot of my pantry essentials, but then there's a couple of new ones that I wanted to try out. Now, you guys know we like I don't buy soda, but we do have to have our fizz, and we do have a soda stream, but we need to replace the fizz part of it. So I have been buying the soda water over at Trader Joe's, and now they have a lot of varieties. Before, they used to just have the lime, the orange, and then I think it was like the berry, but now they have cranberry clementine, they have a pineapple, they have a sangria, they have a couple of different new ones. So I think in total there's at least like seven or eight different flavors. So it's really nice that they do have that variety. And for this tall size, it is only 99 cents. And we like to drink it, like I said, because I don't buy soda. So when the kids have a fizz, fizz attack, I call it a fizz attack, then we just do our soda stream or I buy the soda water. And we always have to have juice, and I tend to buy the pineapple juice over at Trader Joe's. I have found that Trader Joe's is the only one that offers the pure pineapple juice in a large container such as this. Usually it's on those Dole cans that's in the pantry aisle, but I do like it into the refrigerator aisle. And a large size at that, because it does last a while. My kids love pineapple juice, and then I also like to add it on to smoothies. This is my sweetener for my smoothies. Okay, some of my basic necessities is, I just got these two. Orange chicken. This is so perfect when the cheerleader girls are here, or when Jonathan wants to cook something for the girls, for the kids, then it's something that he can easily do. He microwaves it first. I have him microwave it just to make it easier to cook for him. And then I have him cut it into little smaller pieces because of the three-year-old and Danny. And then they just put it over white rice, fresh steamed white rice. And then they pour sriracha over it. Oh my gosh, so delicious. It tastes exactly like Panda Express. So really like that. And you guys know we love our Japanese style fried rice. I also add, because I'm always cooking white rice. The family loves white rice. We're Filipinos. So if I have leftover white rice from the night before, I'll add it onto this so that it doesn't feel as greasy. Even though you're only adding like a little bit of olive oil onto this, and then it cooks really nice. It just seems to have like that greasy feel. So I add some of the white rice, and it takes that away. I wanted to get some salad, so I got the Sorrento. It's got baby arugula blend, baby arugula, baby spinach, and then baby lettuce. And this is roughly, I don't know, I think $1.99. But it's nice, and I always get the ones at the end. And it's nice for the girls to pack for their lunch, and then the leftover for me to have during my lunch. And then I have grilled chicken. I always tell you guys, I grill lemon pepper chicken, and then I put the extras into the freezer, and then that way I put whatever we may need for the salad for the next day, I put that pieces over onto the refrigerator. It will thaw out, and then I'll slice it in the morning, put some into the girl's salad, put some aside for me, and then I'll even add some avocados in there if we have some ripe avocados. Okay. I have to have lemon in the house. I have to have fresh lemon at all times, because when I'm brewing my hot water with my hot tea kettle, I put a slice, just one slice in there, and then it makes it really nice and lemony in flavor. I'll also put a slice of lemon onto my bottled water, because I cannot drink plain water for the life of me. I don't know why. I just have to have some sort of flavoring into my water. May it be cucumber or mint, but I haven't been growing my mint. We live in the Pacific Northwest. It's still freezing temperature in here most nights. But I have also added like orange slices or strawberries, anything to flavor up my plain water. That's how I drink more water. And then I love these avocados over at Trader Joe's. They're called the Teeny Tiny, and I believe they're $2.99. There's like, I think six count. They are the perfect size because look how small they are. It was a midweek trip to Trader Joe's last week, and I only bought like 3 items. And I really love my avocado over a toast bread and then over easy eggs for my breakfast or my brunch. And that alone lasts me for a couple of hours because I have been trying to watch what I eat. So that's a perfect meal for me to have every other day. And I love these are perfect sizes for that. When I bought that big one over at Trader Joe's, I had to cut the slice and then refrigerate it, and then it turns brown. You scrape it off, but still, this is a perfect perfect size for a single serving. So I got that. I love zucchini squash. So how I cook the zucchini squash is that I grill it, but if I'm not grilling it, then I just cut it into little round slices, saute it over avocado oil or olive oil, and add some tomatoes in there or just by itself, put it onto my salad, then it gives me that nice crunch taste to it. So it gives it a variety of, instead of just all these greens. So I do like to add that. And then I also like these lemon pepper, is it pappardelle pasta? So I buy this once in a while. I saute this with spinach and Alfredo sauce, and then add some garlic, fresh garlic in there, and it's absolutely delicious. Again, when I have my grilled chicken or when I have Costco rotisserie chicken, add that in there, and then it's a meal in itself for lunch for the family. This I posted on Instagram. They just started having this. This is the baked churro bites, crispy baked corn puffs coated with cinnamon and brown sugar. This is our treat. This is absolutely amazing. It tastes exactly like churros. Amazing. Okay, so that's good. And then I bought this like 2 months ago, but I could not find it. I think one of my friends came over and we were baking, and she brought some supplies with her, and then she ended up taking it home, which no biggie. I do like to get the baking powder over at Trader Joe's, as well as the baking soda now. So I just got this. I think like $1.99, somewhere there. But Jonathan loves mozzarella cheese sticks, and then I wanted to try this out onto the air fryer that I will be uploading. Avalon Bay was nice enough to give me an air fryer to try out and give my subscribers a discounted code. I will attach that to the bottom of the link. But we tried it earlier today. It's amazing. I loved it. I love how the sweet potato fries cooked in half the time as if compared to if I had baked it over into the oven. So Jonathan, this is his favorite mozzarella stick, so I wanted to go ahead and try this into the air fryer as well. So looking forward to that. Danica shopped with me, and I just purposely had that small little baby cart, so whatever I could fit in there, that was it. Like I said, because for the fact that I know I have plenty of food into the pantry and the refrigerator, my freezer downstairs is packed with meat because I had gone to the commissary and I spent way over $200 of nothing but meat. I don't show you guys this, like as you guys can tell, these are just everyday necessities like the butter and the cereals and the snacks for the kids and the salads. We go through these throughout the days within a week or 2 weeks time frame, so I always have to replenish, and that's what I show you guys with Trader Joe's. And then when I go to Costco, I do buy stuff that especially if it's on sale, because if it saves me $4, $5 and buying it bulk and I know that my family will eat it, I will definitely buy it over at Costco. But Danica goes, I want some grapes, Mom. So I bought her these grapes, and I like it because grapes are easily can be washed, put into a bowl, and then the kids can munch on it throughout the day. Danica can munch on it throughout the day, and it's a very healthy snack. So got that. Also got hubby some habanero ghost pepper salsa, extra hot. Usually with my hauls, you guys see me with the medium salsa, and he loves that. It's got that smoky tomato taste to it, but this one says extra hot, so I know hubby will love that one to try. And this one is one of their new items as well, along with this one. This one I bought into the new aisle section. Every time I go to Trader Joe's, I love looking at the new items because I love buying food at Trader Joe's. They do have amazing quality, and the prices is really nice and affordable. I have enjoyed it for many years, so I like to try out new products over at Trader Joe's. This one is organic coconut sesame seed cluster snack. Crunchy coconut clusters with black and white sesame seeds. And says that you can add it on. It says try them by the handful as a snack. Sprinkle them over a salad. So I'm planning on adding it onto my salad. Or pile them high atop a bowl of ice cream. I don't usually buy ice cream. We're not an ice cream family. The kids are. And hubby is. So if I buy ice cream, it's just gone so fast. So I try not to buy it. But once in a while during the summer, I will have some ice cream. Okay, and then I bought this Applegate Naturals, no antibiotics ever, Applegate Humanely Raised Smoked Turkey Breast. So I've never tried this. I wanted to give it a shot because the regular deli meat that I buy, they either run out of it so fast or they only have a limited amount. But it's been, I've had many trips to Trader Joe's to where they ran out. So I wanted to try this one, smoked turkey breast for luncheon meat. And then, of course, with the luncheon meat, my family loves Munster cheese. They use this for their deli sandwiches as well as for like grilled cheese sandwich. This is so good with grilled cheese sandwich. And I'm not a cheesy kind of person. So, but I do like that with grilled cheese. And then hubby and I have been loving our widening our adventure of cheese. So I bought this one time and I really liked it. And this is Camembert soft ripened cheese, and it's $4.55 for 0.57 pound. And I liked it. It has a very soft, mild taste to it. So I have been loving like the crackers. I think I still have a box of the pita small chip crackers, so I'll put that into the microwave along with this because I like the cheese nice and soft. So just for like 30 or 40 seconds to get the cheese nicely melted, we'll get the pita chips and dip it in there. And then I also bought this sun-dried tomatoes in olive oil to go along with the cheese and the crackers as our, we don't go out. So when we have wine, we've been venturing out and trying out different cheese, and then the crackers. So that's for hubby and I with our wine. And then I wanted to try this one, whipping cream. I think I tried this one out one time and it really worked out really well into my recipe. So it just says cream at the ready when you need it. Store at room temperature until opening. Refrigerate for 6 hours prior to whipping. Refrigerate any product remaining into the package after opening. I think this is 99 cents. I'm not quite sure, or $1.99. But I got that to go with this one. I tried this one time a couple months back. The Belgian chocolate pudding. OMG, this is so good and so rich. This pudding is enough to serve to guests coming over if you're having like a wine party. Like if you have a couple's night out and they're coming over, this is enough to take out of the container and put into your nice serving glass and then have some whipping cream on top, and it's a perfect dessert with your sweet wine, I think. So really like that. I talked about this. And then I have been making my smoothies, so I still have some leftover of the mango chunks and then also some of the tropical chunks, I believe, over from Trader Joe's that I got. And I bought this. This is a 4-pack. I think this is $4. And then it's called the Trader Joe's Unsweetened Organic Acia Puree Packets, correct? That's how you pronounce it, Acia. But makes a great addition to your smoothies and juices. Make your own Acia bowl. So that's what I want to use this for. Not necessarily so much for the smoothie, because I do like my smoothies, just the fruits and then the yogurt. But I wanted to try this into like a bowl. And then maybe I could even sprinkle some of these coconut sesame seed clusters on top of it. And along with the Greek yogurt. And then it can be like a late morning breakfast to a lunch kind of thing that will tie me over until I have an early dinner. So I'm hoping that that's going to work out. Danielle loves these Barcliffs, and she loves the cool mint chocolate, so I got her that. Of course, hubby, you guys know he loves his granola bars. He's not a breakfast person unless I cook him the eggs and the sausage and the works. He doesn't like so much of the toast with avocados and over easy. He'll have it once in a while, but overall, he's just a granola kind of guy. And the kids love this. This is Danica's ice cream. She actually put this in the cart, and she said she had to have two of them because they're mini size, 8 mini ice cream for like, I think $2.29, $2.99, somewhere in there, really affordable. But they're a perfect nice treat, whether it's during the day or after dinner before going to bed. It's a perfect size for her, especially for the three-year-old, and it's even perfect for me and hubby as well. It's just, you want, if you have that taste of chocolate into your system and then you get this, you're not overindulging. That's what I'm trying to say. Okay, so got that, talked about that. Sometimes I do forget about talking about certain items, and I talk about this. I love Kerrygold butter. Kerrygold butter is the butter that I use not necessarily for baking, but for like when I'm making biscuits and then you put the butter on top after it's already been done. Kerrygold is that for me, or toast. If I just want to have plain toast and then I want to put butter, I use that. And then I use these for baking. Because to me, one, it's more expensive, but two, because it has that sweetness taste to it. The Irish butter really tastes different than American butter. It's got more class to it. So I reserve that for when I really want to taste the butter into my dish. Got that. And then I'm running out of chocolates because of the holidays when I bake. Now Valentine's Day is coming, and I know that the girls are going to be asking me to bake. And plus, I don't buy a lot of snacks. So I'm not planning on going to Costco this week because we still have enough food into the freezer. And these are my veggies and such. So whatever sweets you guys see here, that's basically has to last for my four children and my husband and myself for the whole week. So I have the churros, and then I have this for Danielle because she's in cheer and sometimes she gets really hungry after school. But I have the pudding, and then I have the ice cream. I have this, and then that's about it. This blondie bar that Danielle can, or Jonathan can bake that. But then that's when I make my own treats for them. So I have been making the macarons, and then I made a very fudgy chocolate brownie cookie for them. So it's more of like a homemade cookies or sweet treats for them aside from these. So I do know that I need to need to stock up on my butters and my chocolates. Danielle will microwave this in the morning, and she will pack it for lunch because she doesn't really like to pack those sandwiches every single day. She'll have a salad, she'll have a sandwich, and then she'll have one of these for the week. And then she'll even have some of the fried rice in there. So that's how Danielle is. She doesn't want a consistent sandwich or salad every single day. Blondie Bar, this is so easy. I love buying their dessert mix over at Trader Joe's because the kids actually bake it. It says one full package of mix, one large eggs, one stick of melted butter, and that's it. They got a good sweet treat for them to make. And then the kids do like the strawberry yogurt O's. This is nice because it's a medley of yogurt covered O's cereal. I find this a bit more harder, especially for Danica because she's only three. So I let it soak into the milk a little bit before she drinks into it because it is a bit more crunchier than the regular like Cheerios kind of thing. And then, of course, I've been buying this a lot, the 12-grain mini snack crackers. This has replaced my Ritz crackers that I usually buy over at Costco or the grocery store as a snack for the kids to pack for their lunches or just to munch at home, especially with Danica. She's three. I found that this one is less I don't know how you describe it. One less salty, so I can tell the difference of one less salty. And then the other one is that it's more put together. When you bite into it, it holds together more compared to the Ritz crackers, to where it's like it's so flaky that it falls apart. Okay, got that. And oh, last one is roasted seaweed wasabi. I always get the wasabi. I like this. I've been making my miso soup, so I bought this to add on to it. And that's about it, friends. That's it. That's all I got over at Trader Joe's. Everything in here cost me about, my total was $80, and so this is the whole $80. And honestly, I think when I spent $80, I'm like, gosh, that's a lot. But it does have my veggies, and it does have the orange chicken. It does have the Japanese rice, and then the pasta, avocados and such, and then the deli meat. And the ASEA was $4.49, so that one was a big chunk. But overall, I think, you know, it's pretty good for the $80 that I got for it. I know that it's very tasty. The family loves it, so I know that I got my money's worth. As always, thank you guys for visiting me here on A Simply Simple Life. Again, check out the promo code for the Avalon Bay deep fryer. It's, I believe, 20% off if you guys give them a try throughout their website. Mahalo, friends. Thank you for stopping by.